Hi, my name is Logan Donahue, local comedian and performer, and whether you are a newcomer to the Orlando Fringe or a seasoned pro, I have some insider tips and tricks on how to fringe. First up, what the hell is the Fringe? The Orlando International Fringe Theater Festival is a 14-day-long festival of 100% uncensored, unjuried music, art, theater, dance, comedy, and more. They like to say the shows range from G to OMG. And yes, it's an international festival, so you have a delicious mix of performers from right here in Orlando, across the nation, and from around the world. The festival is located in Lock Haven Park and around Lock Haven Park, near the corner of Princeton and Mills Avenue, aka Highway 1792. If you like weird, original, independent art and performance, this is the place for you. How to Fringe. Step 1. Buy a button. Think of the Orlando Fringe like the county fair. There's a base admission price, and then you pay for whatever rides you want to go on. In this case, your admission price is a button. You buy this one button for the festival, and it acts as your base admission. Then you buy a ticket to whatever shows you want to see. The reason for this is 100% of the proceeds go to the artists. The buttons are one of the few ways the festival itself makes money. The great thing is, this button is a one-time purchase and can be reused over and over throughout the festival that year. But you can't see any shows without already having a button, so don't lose it. You can pay for your button in person, or purchase it online, and then bring a voucher in to get it physically at the festival. Step number 2. Buy a ticket. Now that you have your button, or the voucher for it, buy a ticket to a show. No ticket at the Fringe is more than $12, so many people tend to buy tickets for a few different shows. You can end up with a week packed with awesome indie theater for about the cost of one Broadway ticket. Again, shows range from G to OMG. You can find out about shows from the local newspapers, but the best way to find out what's really good at the festival is word of mouth. Talk to friends or complete strangers at the festival and see what they think is the best of the fest. Once you think you know what you want to see, buy a ticket. Easiest way to buy a ticket is online. It saves you time and the disappointment that the show you wanted to see is sold out. Lots of shows sell out, especially on the second weekend of the festival, so don't miss out and don't say I didn't warn you. Step number 3. Come super early. Parking at Lock Haven Park can be like Thunderdome. Let's say you have a show at 8 p.m. Try to be looking for parking by 7 p.m. I'm not kidding. A map is on the OrlandoFringe.org website listing all your free or cheap options for parking. Step number 4. Go see your show. All shows are general admission, so getting there early is never a bad thing. Also, for fairness, there is no late admission to any show. It's a strict rule of the festival. So, get there early so the poor volunteer at the door doesn't have to apologize to you when they can't let you in, and then beg you to stop yelling. Step number 5. Go enjoy the rest of the evening. After your show, go to the Big Green Lawn of Fabulousness right in the heart of Lock Haven Park and grab a drink or grab some grub at one of the local food trucks at the festival. Gossip about the show you just saw. Half the fun of the festival is talking with friends, so enjoy it. Well, there's all it is to it. 5 simple steps on having a wonderful Fringe experience. For more information about the Fringe, or to buy tickets to my show, Unbelievable, in the Pink Venue at the Orlando Shakespeare Theater, go online to OrlandoFringe.org or click on the link below. Thank you!